Tonight's edition of The Organist Entertains, we're electronic all the way. You're listening to the sound of the very first Hammond pipeless organ in Britain, which I acquired in 1936. I was just about to go touring the music halls with a massive great portable pipe organ I had designed when this new invention arrived from America, and realizing the potential, I immediately decided to go pipeless. That's how a very young R. Richmond sounded many years ago, revolving at 78 RPM. I was fired with enthusiasm by records I'd heard from the Milthurst Trio, original star of this great invention. All valves and transformers and synchronous motors. You remember the Milthurst Trio? The Milthurst Trio. Back around 1938, everyone thought I was mad at the time, an organ without pipes. Well, Lou Grade was my agent and helped me considerably over the initial hurdles by sending me around the music halls. He also presented that scintillating lady organ star, Miss Ethel Smith, at the London Palladium. And well, I remember her telling me how bewildered she was with the terrific success of her Latin American classic, Tico Tico, a performance of which few have ever been able to match. Thank you. Miss Ethel Smith. Now, it was quite a little while before our British stars started to shine on the electronic organ, but one of the originals was, and still is, Jerry Allen. Jerry has his own individual charisma at the electronic console. Like most of us so far, he played a Hammond, invented by Lawrence Hammond, electric clockmaker of Chicago, USA. But very soon, many other makes prospered, including the Lowry organ, which Jerry Allen plays now. It's very difficult to decide what constitutes an electric organ, and much more important, what constitutes an organist. For me, to qualify as an organist, a person must be able to play solo with both hands and both feet. And it's a constant source of merriment to me to see how certain goons stand up in front of a small portable electronic keyboard playing maybe two basic chords, and then dub themselves organist. Concerning the instruments, they have been developed so extensively by Wurlitzer's Yamaha, Conn, Baldwin, Kentucky, Farfisa, and many others, and the Moog synthesizer, but here again, an instrument affording the player facilities for playing solo, accompaniment, and bass pedal constitutes an organ for me. Even the classical boys accept the best of electronics these days, and as proof, here's George Thorburn Ball playing an Allen computer organ, surely the ultimate in pipeless deception.
I will leave the organist entertains for a moment. The Met Office issued the following gale warning to shipping at 19:10 today. White, southerly, gale force 8, imminent. Portland, Plymouth, Fastnet, Lundy, gales force 8, now veered westerly. That's the end of the gale warning, and let's go back now to the organist entertains.
Auburn Ball. I use the phrase pipeless deception. Well, there we have the Allen computer organ, which really emulates the sound of wind organs, and so too, I think, the Rogers organ gets pretty near to the sound of the tremulating cinema organ. Rogers. I suppose it was the sound of the pipe organ which inspired the early electronic pioneers, but our own Harold Smart was brought up as a lad to electrify his music. He probably even had an electric rattle. That was from his father, of course, Charles Smart, eminent theatre organist. Harold has a superb technique which he displays here on the Thomas organ. Smart on Thomas. Now, although he came on the scene rather later, Alan Haven has done much, both as a player and as a technician, to further develop the field, manufacturing his own organs and his own highly individual style of music, literally surrounding himself with keyboard gadgetry as he plays. Thank you. Alan Haven. Let's return for a minute to the early days of electronic home plug-ins and recall the sound of another great American pioneer, Lenny D., one-time banjo player who played the organ in non-tremulating style before the days of automatic rhythm units, etc., but allowing himself the luxury of a real live drummer. Lenny D. You notice the banjo influence in his playing there? As I said, he was an ex-banjo player. Well, a few weeks ago, one of the latest organ synthesizer instruments came over for demonstration. It's the amazing Japanese Kawaii, and we got it to our Pebble Mill Birmingham studios for Brian Sharp to play. And as we listen to this superb player now, it gives us an opportunity to appreciate how advanced the home plug-in has become tonally since its inception some 45 years ago.
Thank you.
Who else but the popular and ubiquitous Brian Sharp, playing the amazing Japanese Kawaii organ come synthesizer. Now, as I said before, it's quite impossible to include all the organs and organists in just half an hour, so our selection is necessarily incomplete. But I feel impelled to include the other Brian Rodwell, who surely must rank amongst the all-time greats of the electronic keyboard. His fertile imagination, coupled with his stunning technique, leave me aghast. That was Brian Rodwell, and I hope you've enjoyed our little look at the electronic organ world, something which I shall try and keep going even more in the future, and I shall make a start next Thursday evening when I shall be playing in Southend to the organ nuts down there. And next Sunday, the pipe organ boys get a look in at Welling Granada, for instance, at 1:30 with Noel Briggs, Bobby Pagan. Birmingham on Sunday, at Marston Green at 3 p.m, Armsby Bancroft plays, and at Sheffield at the City School at 2:30, Reg Liversidge plays. And finally, next Sunday at 7:30 in the evening at Poole at the Antelope Hotel, John Mann plays the organ there. Well, I know tastes vary enormously, but surely the wise man appreciates when something is superbly well done. That great American jazz organist Jimmy Smith must surely evoke joyous foot-tapping reaction from even the most stolid of listeners. And as I, your old organ grinder Robin Richmond, say goodbye until we meet again at the same time next week, here he is, Jimmy Smith, driving away with joyous beats and abandon. Ta-da, everyone.